They need to start engaging those concepts and bringing them into the fold. The old mall directory is going to look entirely different in a couple of years.
So we're here at Jelena, across the street from the Fifth Wall office, with a number of members of the Fifth Wall team talking about what's next, what's the future of real estate tech, and what do we have on the horizon? The way I think about it is like 2019 represented the culmination of this enlightenment for the real estate industry. They sat out, I don't know, 2-3 decades worth of innovation, and then something happened in the last 5 years. But what I'm actually really interested in is, what do you think is next? Like, what's coming in the real estate industry?
I predict we'll reach in the residential space the one-click close. An individual will be able to purchase an apartment, a condo, a home, and have that entire process be done in one click. We're really excited about two types of business models in 2020. One, the end-to-end platform model, where a consumer transacts with a platform on a really important transaction. And on the other business model, the technology retrofit play, where a software platform bolts onto an existing business process used by an enterprise customer and digitizes a workflow. So an example of an end-to-end platform is Opendoor, which purchases a home from an individual looking to sell, retrofits the property, and then sells to the ultimate buyer.
So this really painful process, the process of selling your home, which people dread, is now something easy and on demand.
Exactly, and done in an entirely digital format, which allows a consumer to move on to the rest of their life.
It sounds like a lot of the technologies we're seeing are technologies that take something offline that's like analog and painful for the consumer and making it really efficient and online and digital. And I think, Kevin, we're seeing a lot of that in retail as well, just how businesses are moving from the online world to the offline world in a really counterintuitive way.
Yeah, it's, if you look back and you see these iconic brands that are developing in the last decade, the Warby Parkers of the world, Abercrombie is actually ground zero for this trend of going from online to offline. Right across the street is a Warby Parker store. And they actually opened 100 stores, or their 100th store this year. People thought digital is the answer, but really the consumer wants omnichannel. They want you to be everywhere at all times.
What does omnichannel mean to you?
Simply being wherever the customer wants you to be. So a few years ago, everybody thought the answer was digital. It's been proven that that's just not enough. You have to be online and offline. So you've got kind of the iconic brands that started about 5-10 years ago, people like Everlane, who said, we're only going to be online. They just opened a store down the street a couple weeks ago.
And candidly, it's also happening in office, because as space gets commoditized and tenants want more individualized experiences, office owners are having to react too and offer people digital applications, better community offerings, and a more custom-tailored solution. So it was previously just a long-term lease contract that they signed and they met once every 10 years.
And I kind of feel like we saw this with co-working, right? Co-working was this phenomenon that has kind of emerged in like the last few years and has now really taken the office industry by storm.
You know, it's really about, you know, I think what co-working really represented is really taking some of these technologies and help them rethink and reuse that space, create a more consumer-centric product offering, but at the same time expand the sort of monetizable pie. What's coming next, again, really goes back to essentially rendering space available for consumers to consume it the way they want and do it digitally, do it flexibly, and do it on demand. It also really puts the onus on the landlord to think through, how do I provide a more productive and happier day at work?
Well, and this ties back to consumers to date actually rank the real estate transaction and real estate owners as amongst the lowest on a net promoter score basis for any of the various businesses that they deal with in their day-to-day lives. And the interesting thing is, it's one of the largest transactions. So intuitively, you should have a better experience buying a home, given the dollars at stake, than ordering a package on Amazon. But that's just not been the truth today.
For the last 3 years, we've all been reading about the demise of the retail industry,
yeah.
Right?
The death of retail.
The death of the retail. It's been foretold by basically every publication on earth.
Yeah.
So, Kevin, do you think that's true?
Here's why it seems to be true. You've got 8,000 store closures already announced this year in 2019, 12,000 predicted by the end of the year. The problem is, it's actually just isolated to bad retailers. So bad retail's dying, but that's always been the case.
What's a bad retailer?
I think it's someone who's lost touch with what the customer wants. It's not just the product, but it's the entire experience. So it's being where they need to be, positioning the brand in the right way, having the ethos and the values that customers today are looking for, in addition to the actual technical specifications of a product. So people are missing the boat on that. A lot of the incumbents are missing the boat on that. And these young brands are coming in and taking that space, filling that void. The first wave in retail innovation was categories that we all know, apparel, accessories, et cetera. The second wave is gonna be a bunch of untraditional categories, things like consumer healthcare, that are now becoming brands and experiences that you connect directly with. And the landlords of retail space, they need to come to terms with that, and they need to start engaging those concepts and bringing them into the fold.
It kind of feels like what I'm hearing all of you say is that the customer is really important. It seems like this really intuitive, obvious point that every other industry has realized for a very long period of time, and it's just dawned on the real estate industry. So it sounds like we're all really excited for what 2020 will bring for Fifth Wall and for the real estate industry. And if you want to learn more about Fifth Wall, you can check us out on our website and hear what we think is coming next in 2020.